Jay-Z and Beyoncé's Insane Mansion Collection. Jay-Z and Beyoncé are undoubtedly two of the biggest superstars in music history. Their individual music careers helped launch them both into the pop culture stratosphere, and they're both household names. I bet that even your grandma that has never listened to a rap song in her whole life knows who Jay-Z is. And I don't think that I even really need to explain how popular Beyoncé is. But the celebrity status of this couple is heightened quite a bit by one thing. Their money. The Carters are basically synonymous with wealth. Up until Kanye very recently dethroned him, Jay-Z was the richest rapper, period. A series of shrewd statements compounded his musical earnings and made him a billionaire. Beyoncé, for her part, is also super rich, with a net worth valued around $400 million. We've all heard the stories about how these two ball out their crazy budgets. But if there's one aspect of their lifestyle that is really worth bragging about, it's their mansions. Yeah, plural. They basically have a mansion collection. So strap in and prepare to get jealous. Before I jump into this video though, make sure you like this video and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. It helps out a lot. Now, here's the insane $1 million mansion collection of Jay-Z and Beyoncé. Number 6, their New York City penthouse. If you're looking to buy property, where are you gonna look? Are you gonna find a place with undervalued land that is bound to blow up when people start moving there? Montana? Anyone? What? Seems like a good idea to me. Or are you going to pick up a home in a location that has steady interest to serve as a solid, low-risk investment? These are the questions that us normal people have asked ourselves before we purchase a home. But Beyoncé and Jay-Z don't really need to worry about all that. With the funds that these two have, they can basically choose the coolest location they can think of, buy a house, and spend some time there when they aren't doing whatever it is the mega celebrities do. So why not purchase a penthouse in New York City? That's exactly what Jay-Z did back in 2004, 4 years before he got married to Beyoncé. This penthouse in New York is on the 7th floor of an apartment building in Tribeca. Getting a huge penthouse in a prime location does not come cheap. It cost him $6.85 million, but it basically paid itself later on, and he and Beyoncé used it as their wedding venue in 2008. Who wouldn't want to marry a guy that owned an almost $7 million penthouse? Number 5, their mansion in Miami Beach. After Beyoncé and Jay-Z tied the knot in 2008, it was time to start flexing their combined spending power. Because, you know, why not? So they set their eyes on their next purchase, a mansion in Miami. It made sense to expand outside of New York, and the area in Miami that they were looking at was already quite established as a hotspot for the famous and wealthy. Even if you're not a fan of Florida, it's hard not to argue that this home, located at 40 Indian Creek Road, was a step up from the penthouse in New York. Located on a small island right off the coast of the mainland, it's basically right up against the beach, meaning that it has excellent views. It was also just way bigger and more glamorous than the NYC spot. It has a total of 7 bedrooms and 8 bathrooms, pool, and even its own dock on the back for those days where you just want to hop on your own personal yacht and go on a joyride in the ocean. I imagine that the Carters fit right in the Indian Creek neighborhood. The area has been called the Billionaire Bunker due to the fact that so many crazy rich people have lived there at one point or another. Aside from Beyoncé and Jay-Z, Adriana Lima, Julio Iglesias, Don Shula, and Carl Icahn have all lived there at one time or another. If you don't know who any of those people are, just check out the Forbes list. While this might have been a nice place to settle down, Jay and Bey didn't end up staying there. In fact, they sold the property for a cool $9.3 million in 2010, not too long after moving in. Number 4, a historic home in New Orleans. A more recent purchase. Beyoncé and Jay-Z decided to buy a bit of history for themselves when they purchased a home in New Orleans in 2015. Every musician loves New Orleans, so why not move in? Built in 1925, this building has stood the test of time. It used to be a church before being converted into a home, and it definitely still has the feeling of one. It's a beautiful home, but it doesn't scream, "Hey, a billionaire lives here." You've gotta love that. Okay, so it looks good from the sidewalk, but what about the inside? There are some photos out there of the property's interior, thanks Zillow, but it definitely looks like a worthy addition to the Carter's Mansion collection. There's a ton of open space, which is highlighted by massive windows that allow for a lot of natural light. That's always a plus when you're working with more than 13,000 square feet. Nothing about this house is too modern, and that's kind of the charm of it. The bathroom features an old school clawfoot bathtub, and the vanity is covered in cool historic details. But maybe the coolest thing about about this house is the rooftop garden. It's huge. And there's even a little gazebo area right where you climb up from the house and onto the roof. You think that they can see Solange from up there? As for the price of this spot, get ready. It's a historic home that has been well maintained. It's located in the Garden District, a super popular area that is known to have amazing homes. It's popular with locals and tourists alike. The house costs $2.6 million. Hey, you know, that's actually not that bad when you think about it. A small price to pay to have a nice place to stay when Mardi Gras comes around. Okay, maybe I'm starting to get a little desensitized to these prices. Number 3, a condo in Midtown. While Jay-Z's fortune is definitely steeper than his wife's, that doesn't mean that she didn't own some pretty killer apartments before she met him. Back in 2005, Beyoncé purchased and was living in a condo in Midtown that was definitely very upscale. Located on the 44th floor of One Beacon Court, the apartment has amazing views of Central Park and the rest of Manhattan. The condo has 3 bedrooms, each with their own bathroom, that look fit for someone like Beyoncé. Pictures show marble details and even a small TV next to the sink, so that you can watch a movie while you wash your hands, I guess. It's pretty small, but it's a prime spot in New York, so you know that it was an expensive one. Although, with that said, we really don't know how much Beyoncé paid when she bought this back in the day. But we do know how much it's worth now. Queen Bee sold the apartment in 2017 after owning it for over a decade. According to reports that came around that time, it sold for $9.95 million. Let's hope whoever bought it really likes looking out over the city. Number 2, a pond house in the Hamptons. It seems like everybody who is anybody owns a place in the Hamptons. So do Beyoncé and Jay-Z. Well, yeah, duh. They purchased their home in the Hamptons back in 2017, scooping it up after it had been sitting for sale for about 8 years. I'm not really sure why that is, but if I had to guess, it would probably be that it had something to do with the asking price. In the end, the Carters bought the home, nicknamed Pond House, for about $26 million. So what did they get for that price? A 12,000 square foot home right up against the Georgican Pond. It has 7 bedrooms and 9 bathrooms, a full guest house for their buddies to stay in while they visit them, and a distinct lack of neighbors. Talk about a good location. As for the inside, well, it's typical mansion fare, more or less. Although it has a bit of a rustic tint to it. Lots of wood. $26 million might sound like a lot to spend on a home, but keep in mind that we're talking about two of the most successful musicians of modern times here. Also, the house was originally listed for nearly $40 million, so it sounds like they got a great discount if you ask me. Number 1, a massive mansion in Bel Air. Okay, the houses that we've seen so far have been pretty impressive, but let's take a look at the one that is even crazier than all of the others in this video. I'm talking about the Carter's Mansion in Bel Air. You might have even seen it on the news back in 2017, as it was one of, if not the, most expensive home sales in LA in the entire year. In contrast to the home in New Orleans, this one is completely new, and it's less of a house and more of a collection of different buildings. Seriously, take a look at this thing. It looks like an airport or something. It's 30,000 square feet of living space, and it has multiple buildings across multiple different levels. When you add in all of the outdoor space, it jumps up to a whopping 40,000 square feet. There's also 2 acres of land around the house. There's a spa, 4 pools, a media room, and a basketball court. There's even a separate building that is on the grounds that is for the staff to help keep the house in good shape. And how much did it all cost? too much. Just the small cost of $88 million. Sheesh. And they still have other homes around the country. Talk about a collection. So which of these mansions owned by Beyoncé and Jay-Z was the most impressive? Do you think that they're going to keep adding to the collection as time goes on? Let me know in the comments. And before you leave, don't forget to click that like button and subscribe to this channel.